salary sheet or pay slip is a document in which all the components of salary is included, like gross salary, TA, DA, HRA, PF, medical, ESIC, and many more. Today's video will be divided in two parts. Today we are going to cover the first part. In this video, we will see how to calculate an employee salary in Excel, including all the components. In part 2, we will see how to create employee salary slip in MS Word, including today's Excel data. These slips will be created just in a single click. Only the formatting part will be taking the time. Hi, my name is Vijay and you are watching Office Monk. Let's start the video without any delays. This is a monthly salary sheet which I have already created in advance. There are a few things like name of the month. It will be managed by dropdowns. Over here, the years will be managed by dropdowns. When we come in the beginning, we find serial number, employee number or employee ID, name of the employees, designation. Again, the designation will be managed by dropdowns. Basic salary, we will have to insert it manually. Attendance, again, we will have to insert it manually. Overtime hours, if employee have worked more than his shift, then it will be counted over here. Salary, it will be formulated. Overtime salary, again, it will be formulated. HRA, TA, DA, gross salary, PF, ESIC, professional tax, salary in hand. So all the things will be calculated with formulas. So let's start making a new sheet. We will open a new sheet. We will start from here. In the beginning, serial number, employee number or ID, name, designation, basic salary, attendance, overtime hours, salary, overtime salary. We will leave this blank and over here we will type HRA, TA, DA. Over here we will type gross salary. Now we will leave this blank and over here we will type PF, ESIC or medical, professional tax, salary in hand. Now we will select the whole sheet. We will take all the things in center and over here in middle. Now we will click on one cell and the size will be adjusted accordingly. We will make for 20 employees. We will select all this and we will create the borders. We will go in view and we will remove grid lines. We will select the whole sheet and we will change the font. I'll take Times New Roman. We will adjust this thing. The column of name, we will adjust little bit. Now we will format this. We will put some color over here. We will remove one from here and we will start our counting or serial number from here. Once again, we will select this and insert borders. We will merge this both. So as per requirement, I'll merge all the things over here. Few things I'll leave. We will adjust the size. We will increase the size. We will merge till here. And we will type employee salary sheet. We will merge this and we will merge this also. We will put a border. We will put a color also. We will change the font color. We will increase the font size. We will change the font and we'll make it impact. Now over here, we will create dropdown for the months. We will be going in data, data validation. From here, we will select the list. And over here, we will type name of the months from January to December. I'll be taking all in caps lock. Now we will do OK. And our dropdown is created over here. Now we will create dropdown for the years. Again, we will be going in data, data validation, list, and over here we will type our years from 2022 till 2030. We will do OK and our dropdown is created. Now we will create dropdown for designation. We will be going in data, data validation, list, and over here we will type designation of the employees. Now we will do OK and our dropdown is created over here. We will drag this till the end and we will delete this. So our dropdown is created. We will take employee ID or employee number and name from our example sheet. We will paste over here. Even after pasting, we can see our dropdowns. We will also take basic salary from the example sheet. Attendance, we will be taking 31 days. In attendance, we want the number to be visible with days. So we will have to right click over here. We will have to go in format cells, custom, we will remove general. We will give hash space space means space two times double inverted comma DAYS double inverted comma close and we will do OK. So in attendance 31 is visible along with days. We will delete this and we will drag this till end. Now when we will insert attendance over here, it will be visible along with days. We will drag this till end. Overtime hours, we will take a generic figure. Again, we want hours to be visible over here. We will right click the mouse. We will go in format cells, custom. We will remove general. We will give hash space two times double inverted comma HRS dot double inverted comma close and we will do OK. So hours is visible over here now. We will delete this and we will drag this till down. Now we will insert our hours. Salary. Now we will be calculating salary with the formula and the formula will be plus or equal to basic salary divided by 31. Here 31 is for days because in a month there are total 31 days into attendance and we will do enter. So this is the salary. We will drag this till end. Overtime salary, it will be plus or equal to basic salary divided by 31 divided by 9. In a day, employee works for 9 hours, so I have mentioned 9 over here. If someone is working for 8 hours, you can put 8 over here into overtime hours and we will do enter. We will remove decimal from here and we will drag this till down. Now over here, we will put some color because it's looking completely blank. Over here, we will put yellow color and font in red. HRA. Now it totally depends on the policy of your company. You will have to put percentage over here. I'll select all three and I'll click on percentage. Over here also in these two, I'll click percentage. I'll take 8%, TA, again 8%, DA, I'll take 10%, PF, 8%, ESIC, 2%, and professional tax. Professional tax is fixed. There's a fixed amount of professional tax, so I'll be putting a random figure over here, 200. I'll take this in center. I'll right click the mouse, I'll go in format cells, custom, I'll remove general, I'll put double inverted comma, RS means rupees, double inverted comma close, space two times and I'll put hash, I'll do OK. So the sign of RS means rupees came just behind the amount. I'll click over here, plus or equal to, I'll select this and I'll insert dollar. To insert dollar, you will have to press function F4, dollar is inserted, I'll click enter. We are not going to drag this because we want this to be zero when basic salary will not be inserted. If I'll drag this till end and I'll remove the basic salary from here, it will not become zero. So we really don't want this. We will put another formula over here of if and the formula will be if bracket open this salary means basic salary is equal to zero comma double inverted comma 0 double inverted comma close comma and we will put a bracket over here. We will do enter. Now we will drag this till end. If I'll delete basic salary or if I'll not be putting basic salary figures over here, it will be showing 0. Now we have to calculate few more things and it will be connected with the percentage which are on the top. I'll make this all bold. HRA. Formula for HRA will be plus or equal to basic salary into percentage. We will insert a dollar over here means before K and after K. So we will give command function F4 and dollar is inserted. We will click enter and we will drag this till end or double click the mouse. We will delete this. Same for TA plus basic salary into the percentage which is on top. We will insert dollar over here, function F4 or F4. Enter, we will drag this. DA plus basic salary into the percentage on top, function F4 or F4, enter and we will drag this till here. Now we will be calculating the gross salary and the formula will be plus or equal to salary plus overtime hours plus HRA plus TA plus DA. Enter and this is the gross salary of the employee. We will drag this till down. Now we will calculate PF plus or equal to basic salary into percentage on top. We will insert dollar, function F4, enter, and we will drag this till here. ESIC plus or equal to basic salary into percentage on top. We will insert dollar, function F4, and enter. We will drag this till here. Now we have to calculate salary in hand, and the formula will be plus or equal to gross salary minus PF minus ESIC minus professional tax, and we will do enter, and we will drag this till down. We will format this. We will right click the mouse. We will go in format cells, custom. We will remove this, and we will put RS in double inverted comma dot double inverted comma close space space means two times space, and we will give has, and we will do OK, and we will drag this till down. So the sign of rupees is inserted over here. We will calculate total salary in hand of all the employees. We will sum this. We'll go in top, and we will do sum, enter, total. We will increase the font size. We will do color formatting. So your employee salary sheet is ready in the same way you can make for your organization. You'll find link of this employee salary sheet in the description box. If you want, you can download it from there. I'm sure you must have loved the video. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you soon with a new topic. Till then, bye-bye.